We're going to go live now to John Woodward in Washington, D.C., where he's standing by to bring us the latest as the Supreme Court convenes for this historic emergency session.
Today, less than 1 year ago, the Supreme Court shocked this nation by overturning Roe v. Wade, the landmark 1973 decision which permitted abortion on demand. The reversal allowed each of the 50 states to create its own laws concerning the legality of abortion. Today, thousands of protesters are in the streets across the country as this crisis comes to a head. Tomorrow morning, the Supreme Court will hear oral arguments in the case of Ginny Mapes versus Alabama, where for the first time, a woman has been convicted of first-degree murder for having an abortion. The justices have been called back from far-flung vacations for this historic emergency session. It is a seemingly impossible battle for pro-choice advocates, since only three justices voted last year to defend abortion rights. And one of them, the ailing Harlan Green, has now retired from the court and will be replaced by newly appointed Supreme Court Justice Joseph Kirkland.
McPherson, your law clerk?
Right, Joseph Kirkland.
It is such an honor to meet you, really.
Please, such... hold your applause. I'm a beginner myself.
You just fly in?
Yes, I rented a house I've never seen before, rented cars. Half of our stuff is not even here yet.
So, tell me about the others. Any more clerks?
There are no others. Wasn't time. We'll pick later.
How much later?
Well, this first one is just you and me. Glad you're not scared. We'll get by. We'll lean on each other.
Very good to see you.
Likewise. Army Library Court, Cole.
Yes, of course.
Ed, this is Benjamin Ripley. Say hello to Rip.
Hello, Benjamin.
Hello, Joseph.
Welcome to the club.
Thank you very much. Dan Morrissey. I'm honored to meet you, sir.
Welcome, Joseph.
Thank you very much.
Sarah. Sarah Brandon.
Yes, of course.
We're all so happy to welcome you.
Well, I'm happy to be here, sir.
And this is
screwing up his holiday.
No, that's not true.
Thanks for falling by, Joseph. We're counting on you. Drop the glass. You play poker, Joseph?
Yes.
Well, that's good, because some of us play at Riff's, and we've let Henry sit in sometimes, seeing as the ACLU makes us.
Hello, Joseph. I'm well done.
Of course.
Glad to have you with us.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
This is Claude Cawley. He's our teacher and the guardian of our souls.
I'm privileged.
Makes him the only one of us fascists that Will can tolerate.
Don't listen to the Cork, young man. Only the Cork does that.
Of course, his tickle, he doesn't have to lug horns with Harlan anymore.
No, you know, I never voted against Harlan. Clark can never vote with him. Yet I couldn't tell you which of us loves him the most. A giant. Giant man.
You think about Harlan Green. He had fresh eyes, Joseph.
He still does.
That's the seat he left vacant. The fresh eyes seat. Get the feel of it, man. We need it filled.
Excuse me, Henry. Why don't we just save Joseph the trouble and give you his vote?
While you're at it, Chief, you can give me yours.
Uh-oh. Careful, Chief. You may give Joseph the right impression. Not just yet. Will and I, we have a surprise for you. Will?
Oh, yes. We didn't have time to get you your own room. So I called Harlan at the hospital. You'll see the gesture doesn't go unnoticed.
Come on, kid.
Good jacket. Thank you.
Try a man's robe on for size. This one's bulletproof. It'll get you through.
Thank you. Wear this robe. You don't need look to any man.
Harlan says that this buys him a boat.
Any boat. Except this one.
There's a lot of pixie dust in this room, Joseph. Keep your pores open.
Joseph?
Oh, sorry.
I pledged this fraternity for 5 years. It's your
right.
Turn now.
Okay.
She means the door. Appeal of Ms. Mapes against the state of Alabama. Ready for a amendment?
Chief Justice.
Before we begin, I would like to make a special request for absolute quiet in the courtroom audience. Members of this court wish that those involved are able to state their case, their arguments, with maximum clarity to our maximum comprehension.
Affirm Mape's conviction. If we
set her free, they'll think that Roe is back, whatever we say, and without Harlan on this court, you know, you and Henry can't count higher than two.
You've got no way to win.
Did I miss a vote here?
No, damn it, just a point.
What is the point, Bobby? Are you trying to cut a deal right here in Congress? Could you hear Ollie Holmes right now just whirling around in his grave?
Vote with us. And we'll draft a clear ruling that requires reasonable sentencing. No witch hunts. No unreasonable prison term.
What's a reasonable prison term, Bobby? For a frightened woman who doesn't want to bear a child.
As long as it takes to execute the law. With mercy and compassion. It's a law to protect unborn babies, and a $10 fine isn't going to cut it, Will.
Come on, Rip. What's going to cut it? 1 year? Two? Sliding scale, the older the fetus? What?
Sit with the court, Willie. Hammer it out with him. I'll go with his recommendation, I promise. Be part of the process. That's no deal.
That's right, Bobby. It's no deal.
I would vote to affirm.
Reverse.
Court. Four passes, we'll come back, Dan.
I think I would vote to affirm the conviction. Appreciate the pain of this one. Life is sacred. You can't bargain with it. I'm sorry, Willie. I'm sorry, that's all.
I would vote to affirm in counsel leniency. There is some right to privacy implied in the 14th Amendment. And I think there is. It does not constitutionally guarantee a woman the right to abortion on demand. Alabama may choose, as it has, to defend the right of the fetus if due process is observed. I can't see felony here, Rip. It's too open-ended. These women are desperate and innocent at heart. I think we suggest misdemeanor. Fine, short jail, 30, 60 days, community service.
Well, how about a spanking?
Only if it's reciprocal. The judge should get something out of this.
Henry, what'll it take? I need 8 votes, Hank. Why don't we write the opinion together? You, me, the court. Send in a balanced draft.
Not this time, Chief. The lady is innocent of any crime. I don't intend to sell her out.
Reverse.
Rip. Repent and reverse.
God, this is... Affirm, of course, but I can't go along with the court's opinion. I'll have to concur separately.
Sleep on it, Rip. I need one set of rules.
I believe the fetus to be a person under the 14th Amendment, which means its life is constitutionally guaranteed, and no law permitting abortion could ever be valid. Dan Morris and I are talking. He may join me.
I don't think the court's misdemeanor approach would give the job enough.
There was an abortion performed every 20 seconds in this country. That's a lot of minds to change, Bobby.
Poor. If we let you write the opinion, would you do that and bring us all together?
I haven't voted yet. Reverse.
It's with you on abortion, Bobby. Not with you on the statute. Alabama wants to make a state law that says abortion is murder one. You're going to have to write a law that's a little fairer than this one.
It's a bad statute, I admit, but 3 votes to reverse sends a dangerous message. Sarah? How about we try it together? Write it down the middle.
I would vote to reverse. I had an abortion. 16 years ago. With the knowledge and consent of my husband. Abortion is wrong. Mine is wrong. I can't put these women in prison. It's wrong.
You voted against abortion on demand.
This is the first time a mother is a criminal. I always knew I'd get off here. You just never quite had off.
Well, Joseph, you still here?
would you vote?
I don't know yet.
Tentative vote? How are you leaning? Ask your damn question. How are you leaning?
Towards doing what's right. When I figure that out, I'll let you know. You know, there's a song. Maybe it's a poem. Joseph, we hardly knew you.
What was there to know? I've never been a judge at any level.
Brandeis wasn't a judge. He did all right.
I mean, what created expectations about my vote?
Moderate Republican.
Made a good living litigating for corporations.
That makes me pro-life. You defended Arthur Jackman.
He was my client, not my guru. I mentioned that about 100 times during my confirmation. Arthur is pro-life, but he's committed to nonviolence, and I admire that. Now he gets busted, and the liberals, they sit on their hands because he's not pro-choice.
So you've just jumped in, dropped all your insurance companies, hospitals.
He is the Martin Luther King of his movement. I thought that was worth a defense.
You defended a man, not a cause. And you told the Senate in no uncertain terms that you had no prejudgment on abortion, so why should I have any expectations about your vote?
Why, indeed.
Of course, the media says that the Jackman case was the only thing that got you nominated. But the media, they're pretty dumb. Just a trial lawyer,
albeit a rich one. No judicial experience, catapulted to the high court because the president needed a clean, charismatic, reliable vote against abortion, which the media says is the president's top priority. But as we know, the media is pretty dumb.
What did you tell him?
Who? You couldn't mean the president, could you? Because for the president to take a meeting with me and pretend it was perfunctory and social and then try to ascertain my views on abortion before nominating me?
Oh, that would have been incredibly improper of him as if he were trying to stack the court. Lucky that meeting never happened. Mm.
And if it had,
he never would have asked directly.
Oh, he doesn't ask. But he would have told me his assumptions and his views and watched to see if I contradicted him.
What would you have done?
Oh, I would have been so bone-deep shocked that I would have kept my damn mouth shut and let the son of a bitch assume whatever he wanted.
And why would you do that?
Because I would have realized it's the only way of getting an open mind on this court. And I might have thought that this republic was entitled to it. Now, if you really want to know what happened in that meeting, let's get the New York Times up here and we'll all talk about it together. Because I certainly have nothing to hide. And when you call over to Pennsylvania Avenue tonight, you tell whoever answers the phone to say a prayer for Arthur Jackman, because he's the second best reason I haven't voted with Will Dunn.
Yes. What's the first?
You don't know her.
This is from Library of Congress.
Okay.
And then this one is from upstairs. Oh, and some old friend of your wife's called. Her name is Marley. The Mrs. Kirkland phone, so I just gave her the number.
Marley Terrell?
Yeah.
Can you give me a minute, please? I hold my calls.
Thank you.
how are you?
Very good, thanks. I don't know. It's gonna probably be kind of late.
Fascinating day. Fascinating. How's your day?
Yeah, well, you know, my clerk said that Marley Terrell called.
Would you ring her back?
Right. What's up? No, it's not. We've been through this already. Well, she's my daughter too, and I think, you know, you need my vote before you do anything. Linda, honey, listen to me. You're not listening to what I'm saying, okay? What I'm saying is no. All right? No is what I'm... Me too.
Nice of you to stop by.
I didn't want to wake you.
God knows what might have happened.
Nice note.
I think you have.
All day long, that's all I did.
Personally speaking, nobody questions my clerks but me, and I don't have any questions. And if I haven't been around here long enough to command that kind of slack, then, maybe I've been around here too long.
Anybody else?
I'm doing it like a book.
Yeah, me too.
Thank you.
Count me in.
Joseph, you've been here 5 minutes, and I'm laying it all on the line. What's wrong, Will?
I'm just wondering about the cherry moon you're in, Bobby.
Well, whenever I get to prove the press wrong, I get all fuzzy inside. You see, they think we're deadlocked.
I have Clore's vote, Will. Unless anyone jumps ship,
I'm taking the opinion. Affirming the conviction in this case, but attacking the Alabama law for lack of reasonable exceptions and sentencing limitations is going to have the effect of making them rewrite the statute. That's what Clore wants.
We're too late for Jenny Mapes.
She wants into the history books. She's got it.
Tell me, what kind of jail terms are you recommending for these women?
Open-ended. I have to keep it vague. If I don't, I'll lose Rip on one side or the Clore on the other.
What became of your distaste for chaos?
I've lowered my horizons. Right now, I'm happy to be able to count up to five. Or is it six? Joseph, the more I know about your position, the better chance I have to accommodate it. It's Saturday. Judgment Day tomorrow.
Woman who chooses not to bear a child is a criminal. Only 9 people alive can stop that now. Pray God they're listening.
Wandered down here for a visit since...
Since the last time you needed something. Have a candy.
Oh. I came for your vote, Sarah Marie. Why the smile?
Yet the way you said it was exactly like the devil saying you'd come for my soul.
Well, if I were Lucifer, I could count up to 9. As it is, you're only going to take me to 6.
I'm writing my descent, Bobby.
Only until I walk down. There's no way you can turn me down. The key is, I have enough votes to win already, so the conviction is going to be affirmed with you or without you. I have 5 votes, no matter what. And if I can't count on you, I'm going to have to please Ripley. That means maximum possible sentence. If you join me, I'll cut Ripley loose, let him concur separately, and you will be personally responsible for keeping the sentences of these women at minimal or token levels. In fact, you can draft that section of my opinion. You're the woman, Sarah Marie. We need you to say abortion is wrong, and that's what you believe. We need you to stand for compassionate sentence.
How can any prison term be compassionate?
Prison there will be, Sarah. So say 5 votes. The only question is long prison terms or next to
tomorrow to lock in. Monday, we have to present it at 10 in the morning, so if you would start drafting your section, I would be grateful. And if you talk to Mr. Joseph Kirkland, I'd be even more so.
Well,
properly viewed, this is the new center position, and I think that's where Mr. Kirkland longs to be. He likes you. Well, you can tell him that you and he will be moving me to the left of Ripley, which is true. Then we can count up to 7. You're going to be saving a lot of women, a lot of years in prison, sir. Because you're in the right place at the right time. Well, that's how history gets made.
There was just more room here.
No, no, stay where you are. You look great, but what can I get you? Rare steak, scotch and water, 9 bowls of ginger beans.
I'll take 5. Oh, that Marley Terrell called again. She said she couldn't get a hold of your wife, so tell Mrs. Kirkland she's driving like crazy to get here by tomorrow.
I'm gonna go home for a minute. Mommy gets a tiebreak.
I think it's a little bit bad. It's also about letting Drews get the tiebreaker over a lie.
A lie?
Yes. A lie. The secret is the same as a lie. Do the math.
My daughter is 8 years old. You do the math.
That's funny. So is mine. She's the only one I'm telling. You can keep yours locked up in a tower. Won the argument for 3 years. You knew you couldn't win it forever. It's time, that's all.
Well, you sure picked an interesting time.
What is that supposed to mean? You think this is about the case?
What are you going to tell me, to witness?
No, not completely. It is why Marley called. It is no factor in my deciding to let her come. What are you accusing me of? Don't pull your trial lawyer crap on me. Trot out Marley Terrell to remind you of our daughter.
Then why did you? Why?
You want to look like that woman? You want to promote abortion in this country? You want to have less babies on your conscience or you go straight ahead? Just take it on back to work. Don't do it here.
Thank you very much. You're the slack in the leash already. You know, it's a shame that there's not enough slack in that leash to protect our daughter from the truth.
I'm going to forgive you for that because I know that you love me and that you are under a lot of stress.
Don't you take the moral high ground with me! You're turning this around so you're the victim. You are not the victim!
You're accusing me of using Jenny to manipulate you.
Just my vote. Me, you do very well on your own.
Thank you.
days. By 6 weeks, she's pumping her own manufactured blood through her own closed cardiovascular system. Jenny's brain waves are readable at 43 days. She's an individual, a unique genetic being. You tell me which side should bear the burden of proof if someone wants to take that life. No, forget about taking, because this is violent killing. Jenny is attacked with steel weapons, torn from the uterus, dismembered in the process. Because we couldn't leave any little pieces of Jenny behind to infect the loving mother. Or maybe the amniotic fluid is replaced by a saline solution and she suffocates and burns in 2 hours.
But when does she feel pain, Artie? When is she cognitively aware of that pain? 7 months? 8 months?
No, nobody knows that for sure. That's why they argue for killing them young. Because maybe it's okay if she's not aware or in pain. But we know that she's startled by loud noises and turns towards a soothing one, responds to touch, begins to cry. It doesn't matter what she doesn't feel or doesn't know. She is no less alive.
I think you're wrong. I think knowing and feeling is a big part about being alive. You have 2 cells at conception. It's alive, but maybe. Maybe it's human. But it's certainly less. Less than that 9 months. It doesn't start off as Jenny, Artie. It grows. It's a process. She becomes Jenny. If you can't see that, you can't reach me.
You're drawing an artificial line. Picking a number. Playing God.
Tell me where that's from.
Who draws the line? The mother who wants to be rid of Jenny, pretend it's some kind of uterine tumor? Who stands up for Jenny?
I do.
And what about her potential, Joseph? You want to kill her. You want to punish her with death because her brain hasn't developed. But if you don't kill her, it will develop. But you kill her before it can. Now, doesn't that strike you as a little unfair? What about letting nature take its course?
Jove.
Will you think about that?
That's all I do think about. Hi, Sarah. Please come in. I want you to meet Arthur Jackman.
Really a pleasure to meet you, Your Honor.
I'm surprised to see you here. Walk with me.
What?
I think you're exposing yourself to an extreme influence on the night of the deliberation.
You're wrong, he's not.
And in this context, on this night, that makes him extreme, yeah.
I'm refuting his arguments.
Everyone?
Except the ones he's right on. Why don't you talk to him?
No.
Why? Are you afraid he might change your vote?
No, he doesn't have to. She already has. He has his 5 to affirm. He says, if I join...
He'll throw you a bone.
Thank you.
Tommy?
She cried.
Say about what? It was my fault. We had a big fight.
About what?
We got into a fight about babies. I know you know that, you know, some people, they can't make babies with their bodies, right?
They can't lose you.
When there's three people in the room and they all love each other. You know?
What?
Family. I love you much.
Eighty-seven injured, 12 seriously. Adding to the eruptions of disorder in Macon, Seattle, Fort Worth, it's been a busy night all across the country. With less than 24 hours to go, rumors of a conservative consensus have evaporated, leaving even the most experienced sport watchers in sharp disagreement over which way this court is going to turn.
How did they say it, Billy?
Oh, it's time to go.
You haven't stopped since I met you.
change Dan's vote. I'll forgive you.
Talk to me, son.
Think about it.
Let's see whose mind changes.
Well, sir, you are the most interesting voting pack. You interested in contradictions? Well, brother Dunn here, he supports abortion and he's against capital punishment. Theory, I suppose, that only children are deserving of heaven.
Are you a religious man, Joseph?
No, sir.
Dan, an honest answer. Did they tell you we get paid by the word?
No. I think you'd better vote with Willie here. The one for my religion, that's what I do.
Why?
I mean, if it's not a human being, that tissue is still some form of life. And what is the competing right? The convenience of the woman?
Bringing an unwanted child into the world would be more than inconvenience, I'm for all concerned. If it weren't for God's will.
Do you know, this pro-life bunch's arguments become a bit theoretical. Adoption, abortion. It's a fine theory. Until you look at the numbers, the reality of what happened, so few of those children ever end up fed and loved on a law in the world. It's not anything like the theories in Ben Ripley's mind. It's real suffering. Terrible numbers.
But God isn't a theory. He's not just in our minds.
No, God is real.
Does he want you to protect the weak?
Well, he surely does.
Does he want you to stop the pain of mothers and babies, real suffering in terrible numbers?
I think so, Joseph. However, if you read your Bible, you will discover that he wants some other things of us as well.
Hmm. What are you thinking?
I'm thinking how much the Bible sounds like our Constitution. It can't cover every specific, so it gives us guidelines. Could justify a range of options in one way or another. If we choose to love, we cannot hide from our freedom to choose, no, sir. It's in our hands to do the right.
What is that, Joseph?
Still chasing it, sir. Still chasing it. But looking at you and listening to you, I would say you should watch out because well done will get you.
On this one. Not even Harlan Green could turn me around on this one.
That's actually why I came down here. Mr. Justice Green, how is he?
Oh, he's feisty. Awesome. Matter of fact, we were talking about him when you did.
You think he's up for a visit?
He'd like that, Joseph.
He'd welcome it.
I think he's waiting on you.
Thanks for the chat.
You're good enough to vote with him. And Willie Dunn's not sure. That's the highest praise I've ever heard from either of them. So perhaps you're half all right.
Thank you, sir.
Take to the chief right off, did you?
Yes, like duck to water.
The rope fit you good.
I'm going to try my dear.
Oh, that's sad. Good of you to waste your Sunday.
Well, like I said, I came for a favor.
Very flattering, Joseph. I can't imagine what I could possibly do.
I need your expertise. Well, sorry for the handwriting. It's just some early thoughts.
It's the clarity of the thinking that you might want to reconsider. Yeah, this foolishness over here,
this what you think county defined requires?
obligation of the state.
Yes, right.
It probably occurred to you that this might require some oversight on the part of the court.
Well, no more than Brown versus the Board of Education required to desegregate the schools.
Well, more than that, huh?
Well, maybe a little bit more. Have a careful son.
The Lord love of the man of low ambition. And the chief oversight.
Well, maybe I'm looking for love someplace else.
First thing to know is, we all vote who we are. This will dictate who you go to and who you don't, and how you do both, because if you don't do something, you'll do. In fact, as in all of life, everything counts. I need 5 minutes. Well, you do have a lot of foolishness in here.
Yes, sir, but I believe in it, Charlie.
Get me to 4. I'll get you to 5.
Thank you. I know you're heading home for supper, so I'll come right to the point. The clerk says that you showed him some notes. Thoughts in progress. Still thinking, still working on it.
Why the clerk?
When I get his opinion.
You thought he'd bring it to me, huh?
Why?
Because I own his vote. We have a long and symbiotic relationship, the clerk and I. Neither of us could be who he is, not the other. And on the big ones, which this one is, I know his will.
How could I have known that?
Yeah. Tell me, Joseph, what are your views on other matters?
Other matters?
Free speech, criminal rights, death penalty, equal protection of the law. Where lies your heart of heart?
We're talking about trading votes.
You got one to trade, son, other than your own? Now, you just pull them back for a couple of seconds and listen to somebody who's older and meaner than you are. I'm talking about a relationship wherein your views are as important to me as mine are to you. I can double deal for worse. And I rarely make a promise, but when I do, I've never broken one. And ask Harlan Green.
Harlan Green? How could such a pitiful liar ever make a living as a lawyer? Well, good thing I landed on the bench where honesty is at such a premium.
Now, what did Harlan say?
You give me the 4 votes, son, and I'll get you the 5.
So, that means Clore, Rip, the Cork, and, me. How many does that make? So I guess that means you have to get everybody else. So while you're home, having dinner with your charming family, I would ponder my offer of a relationship. Because if it stops here, I can forgive this level of disagreement in 5 seconds. I can even respect the man for trying. But if you go for 5, if you really go, win or lose, you'll hurt my feelings. Have a good summer.
Are you going to tell me what this is all about?
tea. Do you drink tea?
Yes, sir.
You punished that young woman, you'll regret it all your life.
Is her idea?
And I'm 80% sure it's a bad one. Neither you nor I have time for this. We both have a night's work ahead. It just can't help. Please, dear God, don't let it hurt.
Well, that's a chance you take, isn't it?
When you get up in the morning, yeah. I'm late for a rally at the Lincoln Memorial. Is that enough irony for you? What would Mr. Lincoln say? We must wonder, you and I, if you could see all this. Your clerk told me what you think of me. And you are mostly right. I am the worst case for sympathy, except perhaps for my color, which only adds to the irony. I am educated. I am successful. My abortion was truly discretionary. I could have aborted the child. I could have handled it emotionally. It would not have even seriously interfered with my law practice, but the father was barely a casual boyfriend, and the conception was an accident. And I chose to terminate the pregnancy in my fifth week.
You have any regrets?
I wish I could say I did. It would make me more sympathetic, I know, but I felt none. Someday I will fall in love, and we will have babies together. These and other things you could come to know about us if you spend the time. But there is one thing you can never really know. What this means to us.
Will you tell me one thing?
I'll trade you. One for one.
Are you afraid for yourself?
Are you?
Yes.
I said you're not eating. Oh, the food's terrible. Well, I thought that maybe they'd forgotten where to find these. This hall, no chocolate, this butterscotch. You look pretty good to me. Seat back, and the chief steps down. Wilson, you want to see me? With both? Of course I can. Well, this is a chance to win another argument. Well, I'm a busy man, Harlan. Let's get to it. Why are you smiling, old man?
I wasn't smiling. I was just thinking. You know what we built? You and me. And what he done. I lie around here and wonder how we do all that. Oh, shit. It just started with this little notion. It's just a notion. People should be a little more free. Yes.
what I came to hear.
Happiest. Court in the land says you have a constitutional right. Need every last one.
She showed me her dolls. I'm gonna send her some she doesn't have.
I'm glad you met her.
It's not luck.
I know that.
Back then it was legal not to have them. I wasn't gonna have them. Did I tell you that part?
Yes.
That there had been room at this clinic or if I had enough money to go to a regular hospital. It's been too late, you understand?
Yeah.
And you're not mad?
Mad we were lucky.
Mm-hmm. Mad because your lawyer don't call my doctor when he does. I'd let her go. The only reason I didn't was for the money.
You blessed us with a baby. And for that, we will always be grateful. You understand that?
Don't change the law back. Don't make it legal. You go in that room and you look at her. You really look at her. Don't you know she's perfect? You think every moment you ever had with her, every birthday, little dance recitals, she does. They're so very sweet at those. Every kiss goodnight, you almost never had, can you do that? And you think of every moment you're going to have yet. Her graduation, when she's worked so hard. Her big happy wedding. And her first baby with those big eyes of hers. Would you let anyone come and take that away? Would you rip their heart out with your own hands? And even if you weren't deserving, if you weren't loving, which I know you are, but if you were like me, and you could scarcely be worse, still it would be your duty from God to protect her. Because she owns her own self, and her life isn't yours to give away.
I think you're wrong, Joseph. How come they ask you if you'll reconsider?
Well, I have considered and I've reconsidered. It's about all I've been doing. So you vote your conscience and I'll vote mine and we'll see how that ends up.
We're not going to add up to much, you and I. Unless we're together. So I need to have you think it over. Compromise is an important ingredient in what we do here. It has no place in freedom is a very precious commodity. It's more precious than life. Because it makes it worth living. It's more precious than trying to win another individual case. If freedom itself can be bargained, then in time it surely can be bargained away in its entirety. And what we sell that birthright for, the ashes in our mouths. Any restriction on how or when a woman chooses
realize that these provisions are the only slim chance I have to get Dan and Sarah on this opinion, because they do care about reducing abortions.
I want to win as much as you do and they do, Joseph. But I'm not going to buy votes with somebody else's freedom.
No, Will, you don't want to win, not quite as much as I do. I don't want to talk about freedom. I want to pass some of that freedom around. And if we don't compromise here, it's not going to happen. Now, this opinion that you are walking away from is the last chance these women have, actually have, to get some freedom in this case. And they're not even the only ones whose freedom is on the line here. In fact, they're not even first on my list, because they have some ability to look after themselves.
But you're talking about the unborn.
I'm talking about the children, Will! The unloved!
trample her in the street as we meet because honest emotion has gotten the better of her. I will not have that in this room. The decision of this court in the appeal of Virginia Mapes against the state of Alabama will be announced by Mr. Justice Kirkland.
Last warning!
Last warning. But this court will adjourn and will issue our decision solely in written form. I'm sorry, Julie. You go ahead now. Life. Choice.
The words we use to set ourselves against one another. I am a supporter of life and of choice, and so are each and every one of you. And may God grant that this republic always stand above. How did we come to this? When both sides are right. Of course, a fetus is life and life is precious. And in a land that cares so much for the survival of whales and owls, there's so many forms of life. How could we turn our backs on the truth that a human fetus is life, which is becoming as we are, day by day? And how could anyone deny that a woman's right to control her body and reproductive function is the most basic and elemental liberty that she could seek protection of? Along with the truth that each side is right comes the truth that each side is wrong. Because for the convenience of its arguments, each side will deny the rights of the other. One more truth and we are ready to begin. These two rights conflict. And we must balance them, which means shortchanging each right somewhere to permit the exercise of the other. Now this is unfair to each side, because each right is precious and deserves to flourish unrestricted. But since they do conflict, there is no other way. We are human. We are imperfect. We ask your understanding of the spirit that has motivated what you are here today. We begin where any balancing of rights must, drawing a line. How many weeks must pass before a state is allowed to prohibit the termination of pregnancy? 20 weeks.
Now, there is no airtight logic for such a decision, but there are reasons. We have divided the 9 months of pregnancy in half, and there is some symbolic significance to this, a reflection of our desire to be even-handed. But the two halves are quite different. We take judicial notice of the fact that approximately 99% of all abortions take place in the first half, and hold that this is ample time for women. In the second half, the fetus does most of its growing, from a few inches to full size. It acquires the faculties of cognition and awareness which babies exhibit at birth. In this second half, we hold that the states may prohibit abortion, except those necessary to protect the life of the mother. However, under no circumstances may these women ever be considered criminals. No circumstance, none. Now we know that this compromise is cold comfort for those whose religious and ethical convictions hold that fully valued human life begins at conception. For you, we can only say that this republic is founded upon the right of each of us to practice his or her own beliefs, free from the imposition of the beliefs of others. Not mean now that this court nor this nation favors abortion, casual or otherwise, for in fact, we do not. Accordingly, we hold that even during the first 20 weeks of pregnancy, while the woman retains her right of choice, the several states may require the following if they so choose. First, information and counseling for the mother if reasonably related to the making of an informed choice. This may include written and photographic materials even if distressing to the sensibilities of the mother. Mandatory counseling with individual or group counselors
prior to electing abortions, with a waiting period of up to 72 hours. Moreover, the state may require a written declaration by the mother that this choice is made knowingly and freely. The choice should be free, but not easy, because easy can mean heedless. It used to be easier in this country to get an abortion than to get a driver's license, and this desensitizes all of us to the gravity of this choice. All of us, including the mother. Which brings us to the most important part of this decision. Because there is one party in interest claimed by both sides in this dispute, and truly, first, with no one. Until now. Pro-life, pro-choice. But where is the movement that declares itself pro-child? 500,000 children in this country are in institutional and foster care. Because our present adoption system can only place approximately 30,000 each year. So every year, the unwanted, the unadopted, the unloved grows. Imagine what criminalizing abortion would do to those numbers. One child in every 5 in this country is living in poverty. Imagine the numbers for those unwanted. We have states eager to regulate and restrict abortion and to eliminate funding of abortions for the destitute. And this results in bringing into this world innocent children in whom all too often such states immediately lose all interest. We find today that they cannot. Each state must accept responsibility to so protect these children. It must, and believe me, from this day forward, it will. We are placing the suffering of unwanted children on the agenda of this court today, right up front, where it belongs. Get out your pencils. For the reasons given above, we find the Alabama statute on which Virginia Mapes' conviction is based to have deprived her of liberty without due process of law under the 14th. In strict conformity with the guidelines given above, Alabama shall have the right, so described, to regulate abortion, but only as a part of a comprehensive plan of child care necessary to provide the children of said state with the rights guaranteed to them under the Equal Protection and Due Process Clauses. By a responsibility to protect the child that fetus becomes. Caring for children does cost money, and throwing public money around is not itself an answer. And cost control is high in our list of problems to be creatively addressed.
Hard and controversial work lies ahead.
The states could respond to this decision with resentment and resistance, or they can work with the court. Find practical and sensible solutions for the protection and care of innocent children who cannot help themselves. I say to these states, test not our will in this, but our goodwill. Let's show the people that we can make something work. I am joined in this opinion by Justices Morrissey, Banks, Branwin,
and Mr. Justice William Dunn. The difficulties of undertaking such an ambitious decision with a majority of only 5 votes.
6 votes?
7.
He's new. He doesn't know we don't do this.
Benjamin, do you have any surprises for me, or are you still descending in this game?
Yes, I am. Unpopular as it may be. Today, with sincere and humane motivation, this court flouts settled principles of law. More disturbing still is the seeming reconception of this court's function and role in the conduct of our Constitution.
Cyrus?